We are outside Interior Savings this morning, where a bunch of animal rights activists are protesting Interior Savings involvement in Ribfest. Let's go have a chat to them and find out exactly why they're here. As you can see, they're chained to PVC piping, and they also have bike locks around their neck, which is connected to the doors. Amy, can you tell us a little bit about what you're doing here today?
Yeah, so Interior Savings is the title sponsor of Ribfest, and they sponsor events all across DC, and of course here in Kelowna, and we're asking them to stop sponsoring such a violent and ethically and environmentally irresponsible event.
And what is, can you tell us a little bit about your reasons behind that, why you chose this?
Absolutely. So Canada just declared a national climate emergency driven by animal agriculture. So by directly paying for events like Ribfest to happen all across Canada, that is so incredibly irresponsible of Interior Savings to be paying for that. And furthermore, there have been multiple investigations done at Excelsior Hog Farm in Abbotsford, which supplies ribs to Ribfest, and criminal animal cruelty have been documented over and over again at that farm. And we have brought both of these concerns to Interior Savings for many years now, and we have been completely ignored, and our concerns have not been addressed. So unfortunately, extreme times call for extreme action, and so that's why we're here today, to ensure that our concerns are heard loud and clear and that they are addressed today. And hopefully Interior Savings, after this event, will stop their sponsorship of Ribfest.
How are you expecting this to play out today?
Hopefully Interior Savings will stop their sponsorship of Ribfest, if not today, hopefully very soon, and we will refuse to leave today until they do so.
And are you expecting police to show up?
I'm sure the police will show up soon, and that's okay. We know that we're doing an unlawful lockdown. We understand that. We have done lawful forms of protest and reasoning with Interior Savings and with Ribfest for many, many years, and those lawful protests have not worked. We've raised a lot of awareness, but meanwhile, these pigs are still being slaughtered for this event, and it's still destroying our planet. So we need to have these concerns met more seriously, and hopefully they will stop their sponsorship.
And how many people are you expecting out today?
Well, it seems by the minute more and more people are joining us, so hopefully we will continue to grow our crowd.
Awesome. Thanks, Amy.
Thank you.
What you're saying is use your sponsorship in a more socially responsible. Yeah. You'd like to see Interior Savings use their money in a more socially responsible.
Absolutely.
One of those ways would be something like joining.
And you know, like, we're all a part of the community here, and it's not that we don't want to stop their business or anything. We're just here so they are more conscious on what they're sponsoring and where their money's going and what they really stand for.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Anything?
No, I'm good.
All right.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, good luck.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Just now that the camera's on, so you were saying that that it definitely, like, aligns with your morals. And,
pardon me?
You were saying that, like, eating meat aligns with your morals because that's something that everybody grew up doing, and that's, like, a socially acceptable thing.
So eating meat is actually not a socially acceptable thing anymore.
Okay, well
that's fine.
That's good to hear. But yeah. I'm just wondering. So, do you have any experience? Like, have you been on any farms?
Listen, I've done plenty of exposés on slaughterhouses. I know exactly what goes on, and I've seen the worst of it. You know, she's been to one. You know, I did a documentary when I was in school about the killing floor at Schneider's in Kitchener. Right. So I don't need a demonstration of what's going on wrong. But my morals and what I believe in, they're not a question here. I'm just here to report
them. I'm just so curious, honestly. Yeah. And then because of the climate crisis going on right now.
Well, I realize that.
The
climate crisis is frightening, and you know, my daughter won't have children because of the climate crisis.
Exactly.
It's scary, and it's horrendous. And if you want my personal opinion, I'll give you my personal opinion, but not while we're sitting around here.
Yeah.
But the question is will changing the way we farm save us? And I don't think it will.
Right. And why don't you think it will?
It's not. We're beyond that. Until people like China and the U.S. are reeled in and taken seriously,
right.
It has to be a concerted effort. And I don't think farming is going to alone will stop.
Right.
Have you watched Conspiracy?
No.
You should watch Conspiracy.
I didn't
feel that way either. I was like, what's the difference that I'm going to make?
Yeah.
Right? Like, what's my difference? Because I own a business downtown.
Yeah.
And I feel like I used to be scared of having real conversations about things that matter to me because I feared what people thought about me.
Mm-hmm.
And now I feel like one person does make a change, and that's like what Margaret Mead says, like when her quote on like never doubt that a small group of thoughtful citizens can change, because it's, you have to think about the fact that 74 billion animals are being slaughtered yearly, and there's only 8 million people in the world. That does not count any fish, any seafood. 74 billion land animals. And I am Matt. I am 33 years old. I don't want to be here. I want to have a kid one day. And I feel that 74 billion animals, like, put that through your head. Like, what kind of child is growing up right now and wouldn't want to know that? Wouldn't want to see what we've seen. I have 13 animals at home, and watching these chickens with the free-range eggs coming from the family farms. And I won't even say the family's names because I don't want to disrespect them. It's not about them. It's about the laws.
What are you worried about? Because I know you're talking about something deeper here. What are you worried about?
I'm worried about the Holocaust was legal. And I'd like to believe that at that time I would be doing the same thing. Women's rights were not always legal. Women's rights were not always ours. At one time that was illegal. I believe I would be here for that. African-American rights. Anybody of color. Race, I believe I would be here. But 74 billion land animals, you guys, it's time to wake up. There's 8 billion people in the world. It just doesn't make sense. Think about all of that going into our water, going into our air. Like, it's not a farm. It's not like a funny farm that we bring our kids to.
But you were saying like an overarching theme here. You're talking about something larger than just animals here. I'm talking about
climate change, and I'm talking about the fact that I want to be on the right side of history.
What do you worry about specifically when it comes to climate change is what I'm trying to get at.
I worry
about... this is going to be the end of humanity?
I worry about protecting our water in Kelowna. I worry about protecting our blue sky. I worry about protecting my right as a woman to have more than one kid, to have a kid. I'm protecting my right to protect this, where we live, that we are not affected by climate crisis here. Look at Australia on fire. Look at Africa on fire. Indonesia on fire. Where are these conversations? They're not happening.
What's your name?
Lisa.
Lisa. What's your last name, Lisa?
Burke. B-U-R-K-E.
And what business do you own downtown?
I own Burke Hair Lounge.
Yeah, well, that makes sense.
Just across the street.
I'd go there, but I just shaved my own head. Okay, well, thank you, Lisa.
You're welcome.
Billie Jean, can you tell us about why you're here today? You personally?
Thank you. Me personally, I'm here because I also was at the Meet the Victims in April at Excelsior Hog Farm. And it's just like enough is enough. So with the Rotary, with Interior Savings, we just want them to wake up and not sponsor something like Ribfest and put their, you know, their charity money and their donated money to the same cause, but raise it in a different way.
How did you personally get involved in this? What started your passion for this?
Just being vegan, and then I started that, and I've always cared about animals, and once you start learning about like everything behind the scenes and then firsthand experiencing it, there's just no other option. And I think, you know, more people need to need to be accountable for their actions and what they're putting in their bodies, and then not only that, but what they're sponsoring. It's so easy to walk down to a festival like Ribfest and not think about where the animals that were on their plates came from. And it's weird, people don't even, you know, they get a plate of meat, they don't even think about it as being an animal, they think about it as food. And I have seen the first step of that, so that's why I'm here today, to be their voice, because they're locked up in factory farms, and I would hope that if the roles were reversed, they would be here for me.
Awesome. What lengths are you willing to go to make that happen? Obviously, you're chained to the door right now.
I was going
to
say, I've got 3 bike locks chained to my neck, and they're bike locks specifically, so I can't get bolt-cutted out of here, and I will sit here all damn day.
Awesome. Thanks.
Yeah.
Supplier.
So we can see here at the moment, two cops have arrived at the scene, and we understand that they're just waiting for backup at the moment, so stay tuned to watch what happens.
With two people in the vehicle as well, seven people still chained. Okay. Okay. Bye.
They're basically not
going. Well, 50, I'm just in the bank, so.
So they're basically not going to leave today. We are actually one thing and one thing only, and that is for Interior Savings to pull their sponsorship from Ribfest.
From what?
From Ribfest.
Ribfest, okay.
Yes. Thank you.
And I don't suppose you spoke to anybody from the bank, right?
No.
Okay.
Not this morning.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
And what do you have? Four people here that are.
Four people here.
Yeah. Well, are they chained together?
Pardon?
Are they chained together?
I'm not sure how they're chained to the door, you can see, but I don't know what else is going on.
And you're the spokesman?
Yes.
Okay, well, I'm Greg Woodcox.
Tegan,
okay.
Nice to meet you.
So you can deal with me and we can make some resolution. Are you guys going to get something to the media here, or is that your...
We already have already. We have a couple people that have been interviewed, but yeah, and that's basically it.
Okay.
Pretty well, simple. Yeah.
Yep. Okay, well, we'll come to the resolution one way or another here, right?
Okay, sounds okay. Great, yeah. Absolutely.
The bank has business to do during the day as well, you know that, right? I'll speak to somebody from inside the bank and come and talk to you.
Yeah, of course. Okay. We have written letters and we have been very clear about
what we want. Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, if you want to remain out here, I'll try to get a hold of somebody in the bank. I don't know how I can since you have the doors locked, but.
I think there is an emergency exit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Great. Thank you very
thank
much.
You so much.
Thanks, Greg.
Yeah, no, thanks, guys.
Someone drops their wallet.
Where are you guys? Hey, Laurel. I'll go in the back and talk to you. Can I talk to you in the back? Yeah?
So at the moment, we have seen a second police officer go into Interior Savings through the back entrance to discuss with staff how they're going to peacefully resolve this protest. So keep updated for what's about to happen.
What would you like?
What was said inside?
No, I just expressed her concerns that she wanted me to tell the executives inside why they're here, which I did. I relayed that to them, and they understand that people have the right to protest. And that's kind of where it is right now. I mean, this is all new to us, but so I expressed her concerns like she asked, and we'll go from here.
Any plans to move anybody from the doors?
Not the immediate future, but I mean, as you know, this is not going to go on forever, and hopefully, you know, people can make their point in a peaceful way, and then we'll do the same thing. But you know, you can't stay chained to a door for days on end, so you know, read through that what you want, but that's kind of where we stand. We're not here to arrest anybody if you're going to do this peacefully, and that's where we stand. However, you know, the access to the building is obviously completely denied to the customers, so you know, there's a time frame I'm sure that, you know, everybody's willing to put up with, and we'll go from there, but that's all we can do.
Are they having some higher level discussions at the moment, or what is that next
step? I think they probably are. They didn't tell me that, but I would assume that somebody inside is speaking to another branch manager or somebody above them, and should these guys want to talk to them, I'm sure we can open up those lines of communication, but that's where we are right now.
Hey, so what's your name, sir?
Sergeant Greg Woodcox, Woodcox. Anybody have any other questions I can answer at the time?
Is it possible for us to speak to them?
Yeah, I'm sure I can arrange that. Yeah, I just spoke to somebody now, but I got a gentleman's name I could forward to you, and we can probably arrange that, yes. See, that would be the best thing to do, I would think. Yep. Anybody get any questions about anything else right now?
Sergeant, we'll talk about this.
Yeah.
What's happening here?
So there's a protest here by this group in relation to the banks. I don't know their... Is it fair to say that you guys are here because the bank's affiliations?
Okay.
Day 30.
They were seeing about an hour. You guys were the same?
Yeah. A couple minutes before that, I think.
You guys don't need anything? You're okay?
We're just coming here to maintain law and order and peaceful protest. We have no problem with people protesting whatsoever. Encourage it, frankly, but you know, you have to know that the bank, the access to the bank is completely denied, and there's people chained to the doors. So, you know, they can make their point, but I mean, it can't go on forever either. But we're more than willing to, you know, watch what goes on here in the foreseeable future. So,
could there be arrests if they don't leave?
There could be in the future, yes. Whether there will be or not, that's.
So right now you're just sort of monitoring.
Absolutely. And everybody's peaceful and they're making their points, and we'll open up lines of communication between them and the people in the bank, and that's probably the best way to solve this matter. Right?
You said he's Sergeant Woodcox?
Woodcox, Woodcox.
Is your first name?
Greg, Greg.
Yeah.
I can't.
Sorry, Greg, let me start of all that. So what is the police sort of plan?
Well, we're just going to monitor this protest for the foreseeable future. And like I said, people have a right to protest, which they are, but take into consideration as well that people are chained to the doors here, so they're denying complete access to the bank. So hopefully, like I said, we can open up a line of communication between these guys and the bank staff, and they can have a conversation about why they're here face to face, and maybe that'll help resolve the situation, right?
So, sure, they have a right to protest, but I think that the company that owns the bank might argue that they have a right to do business as well. So at what point do you need to...
Well, I mean, arrest may come in the future and it may not. Hopefully we can just resolve this and people can get their point across to each other and actually speak to each other and make some arrangement to, you know, remove themselves from the door. Obviously, they can't stay locked to a door forever unchained, but... You know, our job right now is just to monitor this and see what occurs and try to open up some communication between the two parties that are involved.
Do you see yourself as maybe a go-between? Talk to the...
I'd be more than willing to. Absolutely. And that should be my job here.
This is a different type of policing here. I mean, this is just, you guys didn't come here heavy-handed or anything. You just came in here to assess the situation.
Yeah, just like I always do, as you know me well. I mean... The best thing to do is talk to both sides, find out what the issues are, try to resolve those issues peacefully. And the best way is for these guys to talk directly maybe to somebody from the bank and tell them why they're here, what their issues are, and maybe they can resolve it that way and leave on their own. That'd be the best scenario. Yeah, no problem. Yeah. Well, my pleasure. Yeah, thank you. Hi.
Thank you.
with them for a sec. Sorry. Yeah.
So, Tegan, you've just been speaking to Sergeant Wilcox, who said that he'll arrange for you to speak with someone from the bank.
Yeah.
How are you feeling about that?
Good. I would like them to talk publicly to address this. We've written multiple letters, so we'd really like a public response from them regarding this, because it's kind of like our last resort being here. A lot of people that are locked up here obviously don't want to be here. It's just that we've been ignored multiple times. And we think that they can donate to these causes without animal exploitation and the destruction of the environment. I think this is like a really non-progressive event, and I think that they can donate their money in way better ways. So, yeah, we would like to hear from them publicly.
What's your plan of action when you get to speak with someone? Is it to just go in headstrong with that, asking for that, or explaining what's happening here? What are you thinking?
It's pretty clear, like, we just want them to pull their sponsorship. Like, that's the only thing that we want them to do. That's the only reason why we're here. That's basically the only demand that I have. If they want to know, there's not really much to tell them. We're chained to the door. They can't operate their business until they pull their sponsorship, so.
Would you set off anything less in terms of them pulling partial sponsorship, or is it all or nothing?
It's full sponsorship. There's other ways. Again, I believe Joanna's house is finished or completed or almost completed, so they should be donating to something else next year. But we would urge them to donate directly to that as opposed to Ribfest and going through the animals, basically. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Sorry, what was exactly you're waiting for? You're waiting for them to say they won't protest or support?
Yeah, we're basically waiting for them to pull their sponsorship publicly.
And this will go on until then?
Yes, yeah, we won't leave here until we hear from them directly or the police forcibly remove us. So
you've been surprised by how friendly the RCMP has been so far?
Yes, we're friendly. Like, we're super within our right, obviously, to be here and to peacefully protest. We are obviously nonviolent. We are here again because, like, we've written letters and we've done this in every respectable fashion that we can, but we've been ignored this whole time. So, yeah, this is our kind of our last resort here to do this. And we'll stay until it's done.
So, can I just get your name and title again?
Yeah, again, my name's Tegan Gordy, and I'm just the police liaison. I'm, just a concerned community member and business owner.
Can you spell your name?
Tegan, T-E-G-H-A-N, Gordy, G-O-R-D-E-Y.
Fantastic, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Tegan.
You
did so good at spelling your name.
Michael.
Thank you.
Thank you. saving the planet, saving yourself, saving the animals.
Okay, Mariah.
there's also more Joanna College, which is a really good college, but funded by blood money.
Thank you.
epic.
Probably not that.
Yeah, I hope they do.
Yeah.
Morning. Thank you.
We've been out here for about 30 minutes since the officers arrived, nearly 2 hours in total, so we're going to check in with how these guys are doing. Amy, you guys have been sitting here for nearly 2 hours. It's getting cold. You've been sitting still. How are you feeling?
We're cold. We're uncomfortable. The pain is increasing, definitely. We were just talking about this. But it just reminds us of the pigs that are on transport trucks right now that are legally allowed to be in transport for up to 36 hours with no food or water, that are frozen to the side of these metal trucks, that have frostbitten noses and ears. We have seen these animals arrive at slaughterhouses and the conditions that they're in, and it's absolutely horrific. So our coldness and us feeling uncomfortable or in pain right now is absolutely nothing compared to what those animals go through. So yeah, we're okay. We're gonna stay here as long as necessary, and ultimately, eventually, we'll be able to go home and be warm in our beds. And those animals never ever get to experience comfort or warmth like that. So we're willing to do what's necessary.
Right. And so we've been waiting, like we said, about 30 minutes since officers arrived. Can you tell us what we're waiting for at this point?
We're waiting for someone from Interior Savings to come out and make a statement and to negotiate with us on how we will proceed. And to see what they have to say about us asking them to stop their sponsorship of Ribfest. Hopefully, they will agree to do that. But otherwise, we will continue to stay here until that's achieved.
Awesome. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. find a bike in a backpack. Right? Yeah. Okay, try to get some air from the bed. I just want to just come off.
the space for driveway. Right, you guys still looking at them? Are you guys warm enough?
I am a meat eater. I don't need it. Go for it.
Thank you so much.
I am protesting why is it always women? Why is it always women who are willing to put our necks on the line for this city? Go for it, women. I drove down from Rutland just to tell you, I support you, because I am tired of it. Look at it. How many men are here doing this for our community? One. It's always women putting our necks on the line for this community. Always women willing to stand up and do the right thing. When are men going to start joining our causes? When are men going to start doing the right thing for this town? When? I'm fighting the mayor right now. I'm fighting the RCMP right now. These women are fighting ethical treatment of animals. It's always women. They're willing to go to jail. They're willing to go to jail for what they believe in. There's one man and one young boy standing here willing to put their necks on the line. And there's a whole bunch of men here with cameras wanting the story. Put your goddamn cameras down and stand with them. You care, Mayor, more about the media than you do about the cause. Join us in our fights for equality. Fuck you all! Why don't you join? You have. Because you're a woman and because you care. Because you have zero fucks left to give. Thank you, fuck you too, you piece of shit! You know what? Rage gets things done. I got Colin Bazaran to apologize. He doesn't mean it, but he said it. Because I stood outside of City Hall and yelled at him. Rage gets things done. I had the RCMP, one of you, ask me if I consented to being gang raped. Rage gets things done. Yeah, you guys aren't. You guys are doing it right. I support you. And I'm going to leave you to your peaceful protest. But more power to you. I will promote you on Twitter all I can. Because this is important. I eat meat, but the ethical treatment of animals matters. November 23rd, we're coming for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's about time men start standing up with the women who care.
Thank you.
That was interesting. That's another, they made indication to me they're going to meet with Tegan here as a spokesperson, someone from the bank in the next probably 15, 25 minutes, something like that. So then I'll give you guys a heads up after that. So, good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, thanks so much.
Guys, our fingers worked.
So we've heard from officers that Tegan, the spokesperson, will get an opportunity to speak with someone from the bank in the next 10 to 15 minutes, we're hoping. And remember that this group, unless Interior Savings decides to fully pull out all of their funding from Ribfest, this group is willing to stay here for as long as it takes, which could eventually lead to arrests. So stay tuned for updates. We look forward to sharing that with you when we get more news in.
we should get it in.
Let's get it. So we've just seen the officers take their spokesperson in to speak with someone at the bank. We've heard that it won't be too long, so hopefully we'll have an update for you shortly.
Keys. I'm gonna put the bag in your car. What can you guys tell us about those discussions?
Basically, Interior Savings has a clear disregard for the environmental impact that Ribfest has on the environment. They chose to say that this is a community event, but I don't see anything other than people coming out of their homes. This does not support local businesses. It does not help local businesses. It does not help local agriculture, farmers growing like fruit, vegetables. We live in one of the most abundant places in Canada. There are so many different things that they can support, so many progressive events that they can support, and they are choosing to go with this one, and they have no plans on changing where they give that sponsorship to. So we're obviously very disappointed. We would like to speak for children and for anybody concerned about the environment and say that Interior Savings obviously has a clear disregard for the environment and animal welfare.
As to your protest today, what now?
Pardon?
As to your protest today, what now?
So basically we are going to be staying here until we're forcibly removed. We would like to disrupt their business as much as we can to raise awareness about the issues here.
I mean, with people going in the back door, are you really doing that?
People can still go in there, but ultimately it's still going to disrupt people's day and have them confused and at least have them question why we're here. Because I think everybody should know the effect that animal agriculture has on climate change and animals in Canada. Thank you.
Thank you.
Basically, we were told that they support family events, but when I asked them directly if they understand the impact that this has on the environment and the animal exploitation that happens, they said that that's not their concern, because it's a community event.
What about your reaction to that?
Well, why aren't they concerned about our environment, though, and the impact on the environment that it has? Like, that's my question. Like, when you have the right option and the wrong option, why are you choosing the wrong option? Like, I'm fucking chained to this door. Like, it's not a joke. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I did not expect that.
No.
56% of global warming is from animal agriculture, and it's just like, I don't understand how something that has been a class, like a carcinogenic one since 2016, like bacon, any processed meats, and we are advertising it with children on the cover, and it's like, but don't show them what's the footage going on in the slaughterhouse, because we don't want to see that. It's like, ah! And it's just like, I don't understand why we're so afraid of the truth, and it's not disrespecting traditions, and it's just, we have to change, like, the environment. We need to change for the environment. We need to change for our fresh air, for our fresh water, and for the animals.
Did they talk about just directly supporting Joanna's house, or directly supporting the cause instead of
the
No, they just support a cause that brings the community together.
there's a lot of other causes out there that we could do that actually involve the community,
right,
other than people just
right
getting out of their house and going downtown.
Yeah, that doesn't feel like community.
Not at all. What part of the community donates or does anything to do with Ribfest other than the donation to Jonas' house? Do we have local farmers? Do we have
no
local, even local meat makers? Do we have any
no
local anybody at Ribfest? No. Even the rivers aren't from Colorado.
No.
The rivers are from all over Canada.
Yeah, it doesn't
so
stimulate local business.
Local.
It doesn't stimulate local agriculture.
And
the only thing.
And smoked meat is a carcinogen. It's
right
a class one carcinogen. With asbestos and cigarettes, exact same.
They really like to say that. When it comes to the environment and health, and everybody really has is okay to their own opinion, but it's not an opinion anymore. It's a fucking fact.
The United Nations is urging us to eat less meat.
It's as simple as just taking away their sponsorship and just putting it towards a different cause. The Okanagan's really good with being a community together, but it's like, I know that I'm not going to be a part of the community if they're going to support something like that. Like, it's just, it's a simple choice on morality. I'm just surprised that's what they came back to you with. So sorry.
Disappointed?
Very disappointed, yeah. Absolutely. They want to be a community, but it's like, I'm chained to your door. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what kind of sense of community is it to have a sponsorship of something so abusive and just unnecessary?
The fact is they want a community, they want a community event, but if we keep doing events like this and we keep living the way that we live, we're not going to have a community anymore. We're not going to have friends and family. We're not going to be able to leave our house. We're not going to have fresh water in our lake. We're not going to have blue skies. We're not going to have any of this community if we keep doing things like this.
Yeah. It's just, well, whatever, I guess, like, we'll be on the right side of history. I just, I'm not leaving. So
I feel like the tear saving seems to look throughout history and look at that again in the Holocaust.
The way we used to treat people of color was legal. Slavery was legal. Women not having rights was legal. The UN, everybody has announced climate crisis, and it's like, what side of history do you want to be on, interior savings? What side of history do you want to be on? It's just, it's really disappointing, and I just feel like I'm constantly thinking of the children and thinking of children of tomorrow and thinking about just having Remembrance Day last week and like remembering all the fallen soldiers who fought for our freedoms and fought for us to like have this land and this world, and it's just like we're just gonna throw it away for flavor and for something that's a carcinogenic one. It's just, it doesn't make sense.
And flavor that we can get.
Yeah,
doesn't
make sense.
I just don't understand because every other bank is supporting really good causes in the right way. Like, this is literally the least progressive possible event that they could be supporting. The least charity, but again, we're asking them to donate to charity in a more ethical and environmentally friendly way. You don't need to kill animals and destroy our planet in order to raise funds for those who are suffering in our community. And it's very, very disappointing to see that Interior Savings isn't taking the Canadian climate crisis seriously, that they're not taking criminal animal cruelty seriously, and they're just continuing to fund an extremely irresponsible event.
So what does it mean for your protest right now?
We're going to stay here until they change their mind and they agree to drop their sponsorship. Otherwise, we're going to be taken away by the police. But either way, we're going to continue to escalate our tactics until they drop sponsorship of Ribfest.
So your reaction to the news, I just came here a little late, your reaction to the news that they're not just going to pull their sponsorship right now. You must be feeling pretty disappointed.
I can't say that I'm too surprised. I knew that they would latch on to the fact that Ribfest donates some of their proceeds to charity, but there are far more ethical and environmentally friendly ways of donating to charity, and they can donate directly to charity without killing animals and destroying our planet in the process. And it's just incredibly disappointing to see Interior Savings react this way when the concerns that we have are solid evidence. It's very serious. We're facing an emergency. The animals are facing an emergency. We're all facing a climate crisis right now. And we need to take serious action in order to combat this. And Interior Savings is just being incredibly disappointing. It's very, very disappointing.
There wasn't any shot there.
No.
Like, you know, I just slapped me. Somebody's gonna have to go.
Yeah.
Just the media.
Just the media.
I like her. I like you.
Absolutely.
peace officer get here, I'm going to come over, I'm going to cut those logs, I'm going to advise these guys why they're under arrest, and to get any questions, let them know. They're going to be transported to the police station and like a release of some court date or something. Okay. Yeah.
When will that happen? When is this happening?
In the next 10 or 15 minutes, so you guys might as well. If you can just kind of go over there, like where you guys were, and
yeah.
We'll do one group at a time and place them in the police van. And so, nobody's going to move?
No.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
So, we did more in our share. So.
For
okay,
sure.
Thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
If these guys get questions, we'll be decent with it.
Okay, great.
And like we'll do, they'll get released at the police station. So. And they'll have a condition not to probably go around the interior service within the city of Toronto. Okay? So you can either meet them at the police station at the side door parking lot if you want.
Okay. Yeah,
that's our intentions, right? We're not going to make them go to court, but we're releasing on our own conditions ourselves. So it won't take too long.
Okay, great.
Okay? Yeah, no problem. Thanks. Pride, right?
Yeah.
There's a 24-hour telephone service available which provides a legal aid duty counsel to speak to the private without delay. You understand that? Okay, and you're not obliged to say anything, but anything you say may be used as evidence. Do you understand? Okay. We're going to remove that, then we're going to get you to stand up one by one, and if not, we'll have you stand up. We're going to arrest you and place you in the police van. Okay?
Jerry is more important than this shit, just letting you guys know.
More important than the environment?
Yes, Don Cherry's important, guys. Bring Don Cherry back!
Hey, Cooper back.
Probably.
Yeah,
Cooper.
Yeah,
they're chained together.
Are they chained together?
So you can take
them as a group.
Yeah. Oh, so here's the question. How are you planning on getting out of this?
Amy, is this what you wanted?
I wanted your savings to stop sponsorship of Ribfest. We will keep escalating our actions until that happens. I'm extremely disappointed in Interior Savings, and we'll keep escalating our actions until they stop sponsorship. We're not going to stop. We're facing a climate emergency right now. The animals are facing a serious emergency, and it deserves to be acknowledged.
If not, we're going to have to...
Just slide right to the back there, okay?
You guys are holding on to them on this side.
You all right? Super. Just hang tough. I think we're coming up with a solution here.
Have to do more.
Exactly. Just 1 sec here, let's see if they... Is that actually working?
Can they get into the van?
I'm not sure. I just got here.
Okay. Maybe again, we'll wait to get Carl to come over and we'll cut this one too. I think I needed a bigger, longer van.
So Eugene, you're crying now. Tell me what's going through your mind.
You can bring that over, Sean. We can try to cut it. I don't know. Are they fitting in there? Achieve something today?
I don't know. We just had hope for them. To make a change, but what else can
we
do?
Wherever you guys, you might just want to go
through something.
Sure.
Make sure you don't get hit.
Yeah. Okay, thanks.
One of these.
Yep. Sorry. Put that over there, Sean, we'll just come back. We'll try to get these guys all stand up at the same time here. Hey Ian, come over here. We'll have these guys stand up all three at a time so they don't hurt your arms here. Okay, you want to get right there? Somebody right there? Let's just... Is this your bag?
Yeah.
Not your bowler.
That's mine. Oh.
Okay, maybe. We'll just try to walk towards that place, man, if you can. The back door is open as well. I think we're waiting.
please. Okay. We'll just put them over here. John, you got that?
Yeah.
Obviously, we're waiting to get some kind of transport here, okay? So, or things we can do. Well, they got the engine inside the hand, all inside the camp. We're trying to do this. When somebody puts it in and the other one.
I think what's going through my mind right now is just like, I honestly just like, want to believe that this all does stand for something and positive things do happen, because if even one person could just think for a moment what you'd want your kids to one day look back for, which side of history you're on for, you know, whether we like it or not, this is happening. Do you think any of us want to be here right now? Does it look like I want to be here? People saying how many mean things to us, yelling things. Do you think that feels good? What feels good is that maybe, just maybe, one person will think to themselves, 74 billion animals are killed every single year for our consumption. You could feed world hunger four times over with that. Four times over, you could feed the world with what we feed animals for slaughter, not including fish, not including seafood. Every plant-based person I've ever met, including myself, has for over half my life said I could not live without bacon. Could not live without cheese, could not live without dairy. I am not special. I am nobody special. But I am standing up for what I believe in. You know what, sir? No. No.
Oh, yeah.
It's not the same.
Okay. I'm peacefully protesting myself here.
The first thing you're going to do is call out all of our clothing? Vegan.
Right across the street. Yep. Right across the street.
Just a little support.
second. Fingers clean. Yeah, that guy was eating a burger and he said he was peacefully protesting.
Interior Savings, and we hope that eventually they will come to their senses and realize that being on the right side is stopping sponsorship of Ribfest.
I saw a few people making remarks to you that weren't very supportive.
We understand that this is a emotionally triggering topic. People get very upset about it. People feel very protective over their consumption of animals, and we understand that it's a part of our cultures and our traditions and our beliefs, but ultimately it's unnecessary. It's unnecessary violence. We don't need to be participating in that. We do not need animal products in order to survive or be healthy. So therefore it's just unjustifiable violence, and meanwhile it's destroying our planet. The planet that we all live on is going to affect all of us, including Interior Savings and their employees.
Will we likely be seeing more actions like what we saw today?
Absolutely. We're going to continue escalating our tactics until we are taken seriously, and until Interior Savings stops their sponsorship, and until Ribfest is shut down. This is just the beginning. We're not going to stop. So
some
long as animals
say,
are being tortured.
Some people might say that an event like this kind of puts up a barrier, like it brings anger out in people and maybe doesn't foster that dialogue.
We've tried to foster that dialogue for so many years. We have done peaceful street outreach. We have showed people footage of what's happening in these farms. We have tried so hard for so many years, and this is like a last resort. We don't want to be doing this. We don't want to be arrested. But unfortunately, this is what it's come to. And unfortunately, when we look throughout history and throughout other social justice movements and how they've achieved their goals is through nonviolent civil disobedience. Yeah. So we are following that, and we are going to do just that, and we are going to continue doing that.
That's going to be the dam, but I don't know if you guys are going to go over these guys. So it's not going to be difficult back there at all. Just all be back there. If there's any questions, just ask me. Okay? And we just recommend charges and cocktails. What did they answer? Based on the factors of violence, so that's all right. So we just did that because we didn't think there's any likelihood this is going to stop for a while. So. Should be. Mm-hmm.
you.
Thank you.
I'm trying to say that you shouldn't be subjected to laws that other people aren't in the city.
I think we're ready just to leave it as it is, if that's okay with everybody. We did our best, so that's the best you can do.
We're still on a winning team.
The virtue signaling points.
Locked up in cages that they literally can't turn around, like massive animals, like half the size of a horse, like three quarters of the size of a horse in a cage where she can't even turn around, and it's really overwhelming to even think about the farm. It's so overwhelming for me right now to think about the farm, never mind being the animal that's in that farm, not able to turn around and pregnant. And we watch the videos of them putting their whole arm inside of the pig, like of a female pig, over and over, and then smoking a cigarette and then putting his hand fully inside of her. It's like, it's so bad. It's like the worst thing ever. It's the worst thing ever. Fuck. I just like can't stop thinking about kids. I'm sorry. I just keep thinking about them, and we bring them to farms and sanctuaries and teach them to love animals. And then it's like, nobody, and I hope, I dare everybody watching these, like, in, like, this is, like, this is the only thing I'm asking for support, is just watch the videos of Excelsior, the behind the scenes footage.
And that is every single farm. There are no good farms. Every single farm mutilates their pigs without anesthetics and impregnates them, like, in cages that they can't turn around. They're impregnating them and then keeping them in those cages and literally mutilating them. Like, with X-Acto knives, like, there are no laws for these animals. The legal way to kill a piglet in our Canadian handbook is to grab its hind legs and smash its face against concrete. That's the legal way to kill a piglet in Canada. That's a recommended way, to grab it by its little baby back legs and smash its face onto the cement. Like, it's so sad. And why are we sponsoring a Ribfest? Why do we have a Ribfest?
It's beyond me.
Just try to think of the things you read online and like see about the dog meat eating festivals, and it's just like, I don't know, it's just like you have no idea what we're eating, not to mention it's a carcinogenic one. Like a carcinogenic one. And this is what we're doing, like, I don't know. Just own it.
They are owning it.
No, but own it by saying, I've received these letters, we've seen this, and we don't care. Own it that way. Not lying and not shaming. Own it. We're obviously owning being here.
Can you turn it off?
started.
I just don't even try.
Weird tilting and shit.
Should just be with you, okay? Okay, it's just pizza, okay?
Thanks for sharing, everybody who's tuned in.
The farm is just like hitting me so hard right now.
Our warm access have already been taken to the station in a cargo van. In these tubes, they're not simply just holding the tubes. They are indeed chained together, so they cannot be forcibly removed.
Really?
They'll be using a hacksaw to cut the tubes, so they can take them apart.
Sure.
We're looking to put you in the cellar, nothing will get to squid.
Just all I can see is like, when there I close my eyes, is the pigs and the farm.
That's a good thing, right? Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, when you're chained to a door, that can't go on forever either, can it?
Yeah.
Can it?
No.
Okay.
But
well,
still, it's, they're doing something for the environment.
I know.
And they're not supposed to be.
And I applaud them for that. I'm not saying that's a bad thing.
Okay, why did you choose?
Because you know why I choose to arrest them? Because they made the offer that they didn't want to move. They told me they weren't going to be a move unless I arrested them.
Yeah, but they care about the animals.
I know. I have an animal. I love my animal. I totally understand. They're not arresting them because they care for animals.
Well, why then?
Because
they're blocking the way to care about the animals.
Yep. Yeah. But if they weren't going to move, are we going to leave them here for like a week straight chained to a door?
If it would change, yeah.
Oh, I know. But we can't. That's the problem. Right? They're not going to treated bad, are they?
Well, they're going to get arrested.
Yeah.
That's not a good thing.
No, it's not. But when you have an opportunity to move, then you have to.
Well, they're not gonna because they care about the animals.
I know. So do I. So do a lot of other people here, right? But there's ways to care about animals, but you can't stay chained to a door all day.
Well, if they choose so.
Yeah, but then there's consequences to that choice, right? Okay, well, that's what the consequence is. They got treated pretty nice by me today, trust me. I don't think anybody would disagree with that, right? But at the end of the day, I have a job and there's a business, and I asked them to move and they wouldn't move, so I don't know what you expect me to do. I think it's great that you care about the animals and continue to do it. I'm not the politician, I'm just a policeman. Right? Take that to the politicians and keep fighting for what you want. That's fine. It's good. Right?
Yeah.
Nothing
thanks,
bad
buddy.
About that.
You should take it to the politicians.
Yeah.
You should.
Good job, kid.
Yeah.
Good job.
Take it
to
the
politicians. Okay, ladies, let's see if we can back you guys up. Okay, watch out, guys. We're just going that way. Just to that white van.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, that's right.
Thank you.
this live stream.
They said it would be really quick.
Oh, really?
What the officer told me, so hopefully, unless they change their minds.
Okay.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, we're just going to show our support at the actual police station, and then that'll be it.
Because I have to keep this video in, so I just want to make sure that I'm not missing anything.
Something major? No,
nothing.
Oh, no, it's okay. No, nothing major should be going on. We're just going to wait till I come out. Thank you for coming. Have a really good day. Okay.